Hey, we're Mortgage Nerd here. So foreclosures have started. Evictions have started. What does that mean for you? What does it mean for the tsunami of foreclosures and the crashing markets that are coming? Well, it doesn't mean much. I mean, foreclosures are here. Fine. Do you understand the amount of demand that there is for buying homes? It's off the charts. Not only is there more money in circulation, which people are like, how does that mean that there are more people buying property or whatever? Yeah, I'll explain that. There's more money in circulation. The largest segment of our population, the millennials, I'm kind of like the border, I'm 1980, I'm 41. Now, in the 30s, pretty much everyone in their 30s is millennial. And the average first-time home buyer historically is 33 years old. So the largest portion of our population is around the age of the first-time home buyer, and they have the lowest rates in history, and all this free money just free-ished. There's all this free money. I'll give you an example. A client called me and he's like, "Oye, mira, Philly, yo tengo un millón de dólares." He said, "Hey, Phil. Pero Fili o Felipe, I have $1 million cash. I got two SBA loans for my two businesses, the EIDL loan, the EIDL, which is the emergency fund stuff. $500,000 each he got because it happens to fall into all the criteria." I went and I looked it up after that. And I was like, damn it, I'm not in a bad area. You got to be in a certain area. This building's not in a certain area. And so he's got $1 million fresh dollars printed just for him. And he's like, "I want to buy a house." You add that to all the people from California, New York, and all that stuff coming down to South Florida, buying these luxury homes. Luxury homes are growing in a multiplier. They're having a multiplier effect. They're growing exponentially is what I meant to say. So they're going from $1 million to $2 million to $3 million, just like that, in no time. And the 400s are going to 450 and 500. The 500s are going to 6 and 650. Why? Because there's so much money circulating. I've always said you could take all the money and redistribute it across everybody in the world. Everybody has the same amount of money. Let's say everybody has $100,000. All of a sudden, within a year, all that money is going to flow right back into the hands of the people that had it before. Why? Because it's not about how much money you have. It's about how you think. How many people took their stimulus checks and went and bought Jordans, sneakers, or they went and bought Louis Vuitton? You know, it's like they're buying things, not investing. How many people went and bought crypto? How many people went and got into the stock market when it was raging, roaring after it crashed almost in March of 2020? Some people did. I know I did. And others already had a business in place selling those sneakers, selling those handbags. I'm just using a small analogy because a friend of mine actually owns a sneaker store, and he's told me that he's people that will come in with their paycheck and put their entire paycheck down and get Jordans, you know? So it's a mentality. Now, here we are, and it's the end of September 2021. All the free money came out of 2020 and more in 2021, and all that money continues to spread upwards to the people that had money. So the demand is not going anywhere. People want to buy properties. Those upper end people are going to buy all these properties cash. The ones that are W-2, salaried, whatever, millennials, the demand is still strong because they want to buy. There's a lot of FOMO, fear of missing out too, because if values are going up the way that they are, people are going to FOMO. Just like when Tesla was at its highest, everyone wanted to buy Tesla, not when it was at its lowest. It's the same with properties. It's just this mentality. Market's not going to crash. That's what I was getting at, right? That's what we're trying to circle back around to. All these foreclosures are coming in, and it's going to be like taking a glass of water to the beach and throwing it in the water. Mark my words. It's not going to be enough to satisfy the demand, the voracious demand that there is right now, especially in South Florida. Other areas, maybe. Now, are people putting themselves into a bubble? Yes. What do I mean by that? If you went and you bought a house at $100,000 or $200,000 more than the appraised value, it's going to take you a long time, a couple years, several years, for that appraised value to reach the amount that you overpaid. Some might say, well, but doesn't that give you the comparable sale and then your appraisal goes up? No. The appraisers are going crazy because everyone thinks their values are way higher than they actually are because fulanito del tal, Joe Blow, however you want to say it, they have sold their house at X amount. But that's not how it works. So yeah, foreclosures are here and you can get them, but guess what the banks are doing? They are listing those properties at or higher than the appraised value. So good luck. And you might find some HUD sales and you can fix those up. I do recommend that. I saw some online. Pretty good stuff. Mortgage Nerd with the little R, registered trademark, mortgage nerd out.